Singing out from the heavens, oh Lord, that it's time. Oh, Thank you, Lord.
But tonight am I in the room full of an old church choir. Hallelujah. I was looking at my pastor rules. I'm moving. Hey, you can say whatever you want to say. But how many say for tonight that we got the old church choir still singing in my soul? Long time ago, an old fashioned order, I got a hold of that sweet salvation that made me whole. You know, we're going to eat us some food tonight, but I've never had more than I've had when I tasted of the bread of life. Drink of that cup, he said, when you drink of my cup, you should never thirst again. But I'm so thankful tonight. Amen for that. Did you know the song? I want you guys to light this room up one time with old church choir. Amen.
Here we go. 1, 2, 3. I got an old church choir.
want you to happen to know that you know you've been living set free, born again through the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you stand to your feet one time? Give the Lord a shout of praise as your pastor.
Work is the biggest part of the harvest. Faith without work is dead. James 2:14 and 26. Don't think God's going to give you a harvest so you can sit around and get fat. Because in 15, it says, if a brother or a sister is naked and they need daily food, and one of you say, depart in peace and be warm and filled, but you did not give them anything which they are needed for their body, what does that profit? Your year is to have enough that you can help your brothers and sisters, that you don't have to send them away. Now this is why it's not for the greedy. For all the tired days, you thought about wavering, but you stood still. This is the year that God will honor that. Noah was a man in the Bible that did not waver, and he had favor upon him. When everybody else is talking, but you kept peace, Matthew 5 and 9, blessed are the peacemaker, for they will be called the child of God. You kept peace in your family. Every time you kept peace in your church. Every time you wouldn't get on the gospel line. Every time you wouldn't look down at your neighbor. Every time that you treated somebody like you needed to be treated. Like this is your harvest year. This is your year to be a harvest. Oh my God. You mean I can't be a gospel and get a harvest? Not this harvest. This harvest is for a Christian. Do I got any sanctified, holy-filled folk in this room tonight? Noah was a man that reaped the harvest. Reaping equals God's favor. You're about to have God's favor when you begin to reap. Noah, and I want you to pay close attention to this. Noah got a harvest that we still eat off of today. His harvest came with a promise. He will never have to go through it again, or the generations in front of him will never have to go through what he went through. I'm here to tell you tonight, the storms are over in your life. The harvest you are about to reap will last for generations upon generations upon generations. They will be blessed from the harvest of this year. You will reap things that you would only never reap. You will have a special harvest, a special blessing, a special season. This is your prayer, oh my God. Things that you've been praying for years. This is your year that you will touch generations.
Your life is about
with God's favor. Your footsteps will be ordered by God. Psalms 37 and 23. Business deals will come to you. People begin to run you down just to bless you. Oh my God, does anybody in here want to be blessed? But full. House represents a shelter with peace and comfort. A stable environment. This is your year to have a stable environment in your marriage, with your children, with your home. This is your year. I'm tired of not being stable. You can sit there with that old Christian look all you want. My God is real. I come in here to serve a God, and I thank God for everything that He's done for me. I thank God for the cross. I thank God for the promise. I thank God that this is our year for the harvest. If you didn't understand, I was talking about the houses that was in that scripture. Wells that it speaks of is water, so you should never thirst. Wells is resources. Wells represent resources in the scripture. It's telling you that resources is coming in that will never run out. Vineyards in the olive grove equals riches and money. I figured even the unsanctified to say amen on that one. We shall reap all this with no words.
No words.
You see, you can mock me and you can make fun of me, but when I reap my harvest, you sit there and keep looking at your phone, because when I reap my harvest, I'm going to be blessed. You can play clean and wait if you want. My God's got something for me, and I want what God's got for me. I want my generation blessed. I want my children's babies blessed. I want my great grandbabies blessed. And when I'm dead and gone, I want them to say Luke Waters was my great, 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 great grandfather, and he was blessed. And I'm still living underneath the promise that God gave me. Do I got anybody in here that wants their children upon their children, upon their children, upon their children blessed? Four months out. God don't need 4 months to make your harvest. God can make your harvest instantly. instant right now. I said instant right now. I said instant right now. Get your life right with Jesus Christ and your harvest will become instant right now because you're about to go into the overflow of the kingdom of heaven. I didn't say the overflow of man. I said the overflow of heaven is about to run off the balconies. It's about to run into your life. Your cup is about to run over. The oil of God is about to hit your head.
Around us have.
You see, if you want to lose everything that God gave you, get greedy. more I gave, the more I received. I never did have a problem giving because I always received more than what I gave. If I gave $1, it seemed like I got two back. And if I gave this, it seemed like I got that back. If I gave a truck away, it seemed like I got another truck. And it just kept going and going and going. The problem is when you begin to get blessed, you begin to get greedy because you're afraid that it's never going to come back to you. You got to overcome that in your mind, and you got to overcome that in your spirit. You got to understand that when you give, you got a greater harvest coming because you are planting more. And my God don't need 9 months for your harvest to come. Your harvest to come overnight. I'm looking for a harvest tomorrow morning. I'm looking for a harvest right now. Why? Because I ain't greedy. Oh my God. Somebody say, I'm looking for my harvest right now.
Right now.
I told God I would explain harvest the best I could. But I feel in my spirit that somebody in here say, yeah, I hear all this wishy-washy stuff. It ain't never happened to me. I pray right now that God gives you a double anointing and double blessing, that you embrace you so much that you got to stand up and run the church, knock the chairs down, tell everybody around you what your God has done. This is your year. I got a sermon coming out next Sunday. I was going to hit you with the main part of it right now. Maybe I won't preach it. Maybe I'll preach it right now. I feel it. Somebody's like, I don't know about this. I don't know about this. Do you remember when they took God's man and they put him down there and they put him in jail and he refused to eat what the king had for him? He refused to eat that food. He said, I'm not going to eat that food. He said, because it's not right that I eat it. They said, you got to eat it because you got to come strong. He said, no, I'll eat what God tells me to eat. And he ate what God told him to eat. And when he come out of prison, he wasn't one time stronger. He wasn't two times stronger. He wasn't three times stronger. He wasn't four times stronger. He wasn't five times stronger. He wasn't six times stronger. He wasn't seven times stronger. He wasn't eight times stronger. He wasn't nine times stronger. But the written word of God said he was 10 times stronger than anybody in that room. They tell me I need to calm down. We won't build a church this way, but I can't help it. I am excited for what God has done for us. We done. Let me get this back to Chad. That's the sixth time I said it. Usually I close on the seventh. This. Somebody say this.
Is
my
harvest
year. Give God a shout of victory. I won't be able to sleep if I don't clarify this. The reason why your generations upon generations upon generations going to be blessed is because you're not greedy.
Yes, right.
You keep planting fields. Keep planting fields and keep planting fields, and somebody in your family is going to reap what you're planting because you're not greedy. Now, if you want to stop the blessings in your family, get all greedy and hold it back in your life. That will stop the generation blessing. Somebody said, tonight,
I am
a giver. Give God some praise in here. Our year of the harvest. You can be seated, praise God. Thank
you. Are you excited? Amen. This is our year of the harvest. Amen. We're about to bring Brandon's family. We're going to put the year of harvest into action. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's bless this food. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. God, for this wonderful night, God, we thank you for the amazing word, God. We thank you for our pastor, God. God, touch him from the top of his head to the soles of his feet tonight, God. We thank you for the word. And God, we do claim that this is our year of the harvest, God. And we speak it into existence, and we speak life into it tonight. Now, God, bless this food, nourish it to our bodies. And God, thank you for this time again with our family. And God, let us truly take it.